that three-pointer coming out of the four seconds on the shot clock with one there?
Running box three, you know, two screens, one for Dylan, one for me. And I just came, get open, and Casey found me and passed, made a great pass, and I just knocked it down.
There's a lot going on right now. Dylan is being cleared out and currently leaving and losing Sunday. How'd you guys, what'd you guys have to do to rally and pull this one
out? We looked at the film the last game, and we just had to pick up our effort. We didn't play our best, but we had an effort, and we kept fighting.
When you hit that three, you feel like that might be the one you guys needed to kind of separate from them at that point?
Like I said, Casey found me and I just knocked it down. And I think that separated the game right there, and we just had to knock down three throws.
It looked like Dylan came and talked to you after you hit that three. Did something go wrong in the end of the court or something? It wasn't like a stoked talk.
I was supposed to be in blue, and he was just getting on me because I was just walking back celebrating a little bit.
Chris, can you talk about sort of how big this is for the team coming off the loss and with some guys going away this week to bounce back and get a win?
I think it's it helped us get together more. When we lost, we saw a little bit of the team was just getting away a little bit and thinking about what was wrong and stuff. I think this game just helped us to realize that if we work together, we could be a great team. And I think that's what was meaning to work together.
Did this have that tournament feel to it? It seemed like it was really physical and back and forth real close the entire game.
It was definitely a physical game. It was one of them in March games. Intensity, you might not get a call, so it was a dogfight. We just glad we came out with a victory and made plays at the end. And we came on defense and made stops.
What did Coach say at halftime? You already tied game, basically, but a lot of missed opportunities. Encourage you a lot that you just weren't hitting your shots and just keep playing, or what?
He told us the shots are going to fall. We need to worry about getting stops. Make defenses are always, that's how it's going to get. Getting stops is going to help us get in transition, and that's what happened in the second half. We got more transition buckets.
Chris, which one did you like better, hitting the three on the one end or going back and on that same play blocking the guys?
I think I really like the block more than the three. Because, he was, a main focus, he could shoot the ball and stuff. So I think that block just made him, think about it before he shoots it. And I really enjoyed the block and shot more than the three. I wasn't even thinking about the three after I blocked the shot. I mean, made it difficult. Yeah.
Chris, you guys kind of needed somebody offensively to step up. Some guys were missing some shots early. It seemed like you were making an attempt to get inside. Were you trying to be a little bit more aggressive offensively?
Coach always told me, I could be a great player if I put my mind into it. And I felt like if I couldn't shoot threes or whatever, I could still get the rebounds and try to be aggressive inside. Even though I'm not big, I know I could do some stuff. So I try to do what I could get inside.
Tyler paid off for it. Cal was picked by a lot of people to win the Pac-12. What was your impression of their talent level, and what does it do for you guys to be the team?
Everybody in the Pac-12 is tough, so every game we got to come out with intensity. We knew Cal was going to be coming out with the top name, and we just needed to come out with intensity because the next game we can't look nobody off. Everybody's in the Pac-12 this year.
Tyler, now I know that Dylan's not going to be here this year. Is there a feeling that offensively they might be counting on you even more?
It's just coming with the flow, like Coach says all the time. It might be somebody's game, the next game. And, it's just playing as a team and coming together, moving the ball on offense.
Tyler, I thought you pretty much got an eight-man rotation. Do you like that? And the fact that you're going to get a little bit more. Everybody's going to get a lot of playing time.
Yeah, I'm not worried about that. I'd rather have Dylan in this since the beginning of the season and have a deep team. Have a lot of good players to rotate out, because with a deep team, nobody gets tired of this. Everybody's putting the effort and going all out on the court.
Does it feel like you guys, with the news that he's done now, does it feel like you guys lost him again? Or, when he came back, it was kind of short that he was back. You guys played almost half your season without him already. Does that feel like another blow, or is it just kind of adjusting to what you guys have right now?
We just got to adjust again, he doesn't get the beginning. I'm sad because I really wanted to play with him, and this is his last year. But we have to come together as a team. Other players have to step up. It is what it is.
Anything else for these guys?
Yeah.